In the late 1960s, a couple of restaurant moguls put their heads together and came up with a brilliant idea. Affordable, fresh lobster for everyone. Nearly 50 years later, Red Lobster is still going strong. But how much do you really know about your favorite place to get butter all over your shirt? Here's a look at the truth about Red Lobster.
Red Lobster for the seafood lover in you.
Humble beginnings. The success of Red Lobster owes itself to the vision of Bill Darden and Charlie Woodsby. In 1963, Darden, who was just 19 years old when he opened his first restaurant, teamed up with Woodsby to buy a popular joint in Orlando called Gary's Duck Inn, which was famous for its seafood. Gary's Duck Inn became such a massive success for them that they decided to take the basic premise of fresh lobster and shrimp and use it to start a second restaurant in Lakeland, Florida. In 1968, that new restaurant opened under the name Red Lobster. Just 2 years later, they had expanded to 5 locations across the South. The success of the chain caught the eye of General Mills, who bought out the whole operation in 1970. Massive expansion. Following the acquisition by General Mills, Red Lobster rapidly expanded across the country, and eventually the world. By 2013, it boasted 705 locations worldwide, and by 2016, those international locations included restaurants in Canada, Mexico, Ecuador, Brazil, Japan, Malaysia, Kuwait, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates. Red Hot. Considering the chain is nearly 5 decades old, you might think that the clientele skews towards the gray hair crowd. But in fact, Red Lobster is enjoying renewed popularity with the youth of America, with millennials between the ages of 18 and 24 voting it their number one casual dining restaurant in a recent Nation's Restaurant News survey. One unexpected reason for that popularity surge? Beyoncé. Her hit song Formation, which she performed during Super Bowl 50, features Mrs. Carter singing about Red Lobster. Sales rose 33% immediately after Red Lobster got the free advertising from the biggest album of the year. Never underestimate the power of the beehive. Controversy and lawsuits. Not everything is coming up roses for Red Lobster, though. Over the last decade, the company has been involved in some high-profile controversies, most famously in 2013, when a server at a Tennessee location accused a patron of writing a racist message on the receipt in place of a tip. The diner then countersued for defamation, claiming he was the victim of a hoax. Red Lobster was found to not be at fault, and the waitress walked away with almost $11,000 in tips from a fundraising effort set up in her name. In a separate incident, parent company Darden Restaurants, which is named for Red Lobster co-founder Bill Darden, ended up paying tens of thousands of dollars in damages and fines after the government investigated allegations of sexual harassment and underpayment of staff. And the company got another black eye in 2016 when an Inside Edition story revealed that some of their lobster bisque was actually not lobster at all.
According to the lab, the lobster in one sample was actually langostino. Two others had a combination of langostino and lobster.
This is a langostino, and it looks nothing like a lobster.
A langostino is more closely related to a hermit crab than a lobster, so blech. Still going strong. Considering Red Lobster was the foundational piece in the creation of Darden Restaurants, you'd think they would be protective about the brand. However, you'd be wrong, because in 2014, Darden Restaurants actually sold off Red Lobster to Golden Gate Capital for $2.1 billion. Part of the reason they wanted out was the expense involved in getting fresh seafood, especially since prices can fluctuate wildly depending on supply and demand. In 2016, Golden Gate sold a minority stake in the company to seafood distributor Thai Union Group, which will lower those costs by providing product in-house. So, will that lower the quality of the food at Red Lobster? Probably not. Though you've likely never heard of Thai Union Group, they already own a brand you might be familiar with, Chicken of the Sea. And you know what that means, Jessica Simpson must love Red Lobster now.
Why is it called Chicken by the Sea or in the Sea?
Chicken of the Sea is the brand.
Oh.
Thanks for watching. Click the mashed icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love too.